What is up, legends? Welcome to This Week on Gaming, where we bring you the latest and greatest gaming news. Amazon just announced their new cloud gaming service, Luna, and opened up their early access program if you want in. For those of you who don't know what a cloud gaming service is, it's basically Netflix, but for video games. Rather than having to download a game on a console, you can stream that gameplay from anywhere on any device. This opens up a world of opportunity for gamers because they no longer have to be tied down to a console or a PC. Anywhere they have a stable internet connection, they can hop on and play. Amazon is actually not the pioneer of cloud gaming services. Google, Xbox, and Nvidia all have their own services and all have their own set of problems. Most problems stem from the lack of titles they have and on what devices that they can be used. So what makes Amazon Luna so different from other cloud gaming services? Most notably, Amazon doesn't let you buy individual games. Rather, they let you buy subscriptions to channels. As of right now, there are two channels available on Luna: Luna Plus and Ubisoft. The price for a subscription to Luna Plus introductory rate is $5.99 a month, and Ubisoft just says coming soon. The channel system makes it seem like they're gonna allow multiple publishers to be able to make multiple channels and be able to put their titles on that for a subscription monthly fee. Surprisingly, these channels are actually gonna have 50 games each, both on the Luna Plus and on the Ubisoft. If every channel is gonna be like that, I don't know, but I was surprised to find out that you get 50 games for one low monthly cost. Now moving into the Luna specs, Luna will run on Windows and use Nvidia GPUs, which is an absolute powerhouse and is going to make it 100 times easier for publishers to be able to just port their games over that they've already made for Windows using Nvidia. But that's not even the biggest difference for Amazon Luna from other cloud gaming services. The biggest difference comes in its accessibility. Luna is going to be able to play on PC, Mac, Fire TV, and different from every other cloud gaming service, iPhone and iPad. Up to this point, Apple has had extreme restrictions on what you can put on the App Store, including no cloud gaming services. So rather than make an app for iOS, Amazon decided to make a progressive web app, which looks exactly like an app on your home screen, and when you click it, it takes you to a website that works exactly like an app would. Crazy loophole, but they found it. Leave it to Amazon to find a loophole. Amazon Luna also comes with some great secondary features, like seamless Twitch integration. You can go from watching gameplay on Twitch to playing that game in seconds. And for my favorite feature, they have a fully Alexa-enabled controller. Imagine the things you can do with that.
Yeah, got it. I got B. Hey, Alexa, I gotta go to the bathroom. Capture A for me.
Capturing A. Die, you scrubs. Ha ha ha, I'm awesome.
Now the big question, is it worth getting a cloud gaming service subscription rather than buying the next-gen console or an expensive PC? The answer to this question is, it really depends. Being able to play games at 1080p on any device where there's a stable internet connection and not having to spend $500 on the next-gen console is a pretty big pro. The problems stem from the heavy reliance on internet connection. If you don't have good internet connection, you might not even be able to play, or you're gonna lag through the roof. Amazon enlisted the minimum requirements and recommendations for internet. It says, with the speed of 10 megabits per second, I'm assuming that's upload and download speed, you'll be able to stream games. They said at 35 megabits per second, you'll be able to stream and play games in 4K. They also go on to state that the better your internet connection, the better the service is going to be, if that wasn't already obvious. Both Google Stadia and Amazon Luna have their own controllers that can connect directly to the server rather than connecting through Bluetooth and into the server. This is said to reduce the latency effect, but on slower connections, it's unsure if it's hit or miss. If you have fiber optic connection and you never lose service ever, then this is probably a really good option for you. But for other people in more rural areas, you're probably not going to want to go this route. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Do you think that cloud gaming services are the future of gaming? And will you be trying out Luna or Stadia? Thank you guys so much for checking out the video. If you want to stay up to date on all the latest and greatest gaming news, then smash that sub button, and we'll see you guys in the next video.